This conference will now be recorded.
This session I am discussing about sudo. Sudo means super user do. Sudo allowing a permitted user to execute a command as the super user. So standard user can execute the commands for the super user. And we have the configuration file is etc sudo ers. So we can see that I currently logged in as a user, John user. So now I want to open some files. For example, I want to check my log files. So mainly the logs files are stored in the var log directory. And we can see a lot of files are there. Main important log file is messages file. So I want to open this messages file. I'm going to open it, messages. So we can see that if I am opening the get messages file, so the permission is denied because only a root user can open this file. So when I log in as su root means I can log in as a root user and I will be given the password of the root user. And we can see this now if I try to open this messages file, get messages. So I can see I will be able to open this file. Only root user can open this file. Regular user cannot log in, cannot do a lot of tasks. Suppose a root user can create user. User add Harris. So he can create a user account. He can create. But we want to give a password. We can give password for this user. This all administration jobs can be done by administrator. Root user can only do all these commands. But when I do exit, and if I want to create a user, now currently I logged in as a regular user. So I want to create some user, user add Mary, some user I want to create means it will not work because permission is not there. So we can give permission for users. Suppose John user, we want to give permission. He also want to create users. He also want to check the log files. So this all we can do by using an option called sudo. By default in this system, already I have given this permission for one another user. So the username is EC2 user. So in I have one another user, this is just a username. And if I log in as this user, so I just log in as this user, current username is EC2 user. So now if I try to open my log files, I can open my log files. So I'm giving cat var log directory and I am going to open. So in the var log directory I'm opening a messages file. I cannot open because permission is denied, because we have given some special permission like a sudo permission we have given. So now when I do sudo and if I open this same command, I am going to repeat with the starting I have given sudo. So then what will happen is it will ask for, we can able to see this file. So because this user we have given a special permission, so this user can do anything. So they want to create a user also they can do. Suppose EC2 user want to create some user. So I want to create a user, I want to create. So this is not working, but we have given some special permission, sudo permission we want to give. So what will happen? So if I now I am able to create a user. So how we will give permission for a user? So I have in my system, I have one Tom user. So the Tom user, I want to give all permission. So the permission I want to give. So I will log in as a root user now. SU hyphen, I am logging as a root user now. So currently I am as a log root user now. I am currently logged in as root user. Now, we want to configure this permission. We can go to etc sudo ers. So one file I have to open, vi etc sudo ers file I have to open. And I want to give a permission for a user. I can go even to the last line also. I can give I for insert. And I'm going to the last line. And I can add a option like a Tom user. I want to give permission, so I can give this option all is equal to all. So all commands this user is allowed to do. So I am giving this option like this. So I am giving an option like this. There is examples are given here. A root user is given allowed all commands and all. So like I am giving term user also allowed to do all commands. So now I have given this permission. Now I just added this line. So we have to do WQ exclamation because it is some read-only file. I have to save by using WQ exclamation. And this is the line I added here. So I am going to give permission for this user. So that he can run all the commands. So I'm saving this. So now I will switch. I am going to log out or so I can switch user as su hyphen tom. So when I do this, I will be changing the user, switching user as tom user now. So we can see the currently I logged in as tom user. It is showing here. So now I want to open one file, cat command. So var directory, log directory, messages. File. I want to open the cat var log messages file. I want to open, so we cannot open this. But I have given sudo permissions. Sudo permission. So I am giving sudo cat var log messages. So it will ask for the password for tom. It is not asking the password for root or something. We have to just give the password for the tom user. And we have to see that. So password is not correct or something. So I have giving the correct password. So we can see I am just able to open some log files. I am able to open. Similarly, I want to create a user also. I can create user add bush some user I want to create. So this is not possible, but I will do sudo. I can try now. Sudo user add. Sorry, a spelling mistake is there. So I'm giving user add bush. This is not working, but I want to give them sudo option. Sudo option we are giving creating a user. It is possible. So I am again login as root user now. Su hyphen it will login as root user. So it is asking the password of the root user now. So now I want to configure permission for sudo. So I can open the sudo es file. And we can we have we as we remember we added this last line. We added like this tom user we have given. So another option is there wheel. There's a wheel is a group name. So what they are saying in the wheel is a group name. So wheel group have given all permissions. So anytime when we adding, I mean, when we creating a user, and if we are creating the user member of the this wheel group. So I'm creating a user. User add Peter and hyphen G wheel group. So I am going to add this user as a member of the wheel group. So and I am giving password Peter. So if you just give password means it will change the root user password. Password Peter means it will change the Peter user's password. I'm changing the password or the Peter user now. So now I want to log in as Peter user. So su hyphen Peter. So we are switching user as Peter user. So I currently logged in as Peter user now. So now I want to open the log files. So I am using cat var log messages file I am opening. So I cannot open, but I am going to sudo command. So we have to give the password for Peter. Now we can see yes, I am able to open this file. So if you want to give sudo permission, we can add this user to wheel group also. So automatically the user will get permissions. So this is the way we are configuring basic about sudo. So now if I do su means I can switch user, switching changing the user, switch user. When you do su hyphen means it will execute the user's environment also. So what is the difference between su and su hyphen? Su means so every user having when you, because currently I am in the user's home directory. So when I do pwd, now we can see the user's home directory is this. When I do ls hyphen a, so we can see that this user's having some script, everything is there. This is the user's login script. So anytime user is logging, the script will be executed. So when you do switch user root, means switch user root, or just giving su is enough. When you do su, means we are going to change as root user. So I can login as root user now. So we can see this home directory is not changed. My home directory is not changed. I logged in as root user, but my home directory is not changed. When I am doing exit and when I do su hyphen, we can see that user environment, everything will change. When I do su hyphen, and if I give the password, so we can see that even the user name also changed. If I do pwd, so this home directory also changed now. So the root user's home directory is root. All other regular users home directory is home. Inside the home, they have their own home directory. So so that is the reason. And also we can see in the user's home directory, there is login scripts are there. This is all the login script. So anytime user is login, so this script will execute automatically. Automatically these scripts are executing. So when you do su hyphen, this script, everything will execute. But when I just give su, the script will not execute. So this script, you can give your variable, path settings, aliases, so many things we will set in this login script. That is the way it will work. And we have home directories for the user. So if I go to home directory, cd/home, first I go to cd/, and we can see all the folders are there. When I go to home directory, every user's home directories are here. Anytime when we create a user, so the user will have a home directory here. So that is about sudo. We are discussed about sudo. Sudo is a meaning is super user do. So it is allowing a permitted user to execute commands as the super user. So the standard general user can run the command like a super user. So the configuration file is etc sudo es. So thanks for watching.